Alléluia.
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 Children of God, Calvary greetings to you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, the author and the finisher of our faith. The Lord who has been with us, guiding us, protecting us, and He has not despised your prayer, our prayer in our necessities. Thus far, the troublesome, the catastrophe of this very particular year, the menace of the COVID, the pandemic, since almost the beginning early of this year, March precisely, down to this moment in time that we are talking, that has led to a lot of tears, tier 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on and so forth. Lockdown everywhere. You are not supposed to be in our best of regalia tonight, singing and dancing before Jehovah Lord. But I want to remind you, wherever you are listening to me or connecting with me, that one with God is a majority. That He has spared your life, that He has spared my life. That He has not allowed us to be deposited into the hospital or the mortuary. That His grace is imminent in our life. We are not naive of the fact that what is happening around the world is not compromised and cannot be compromised. But in everything, once again, we glorify God that He has spared your life once again to see this Christmas Eve. Let us return 7 powerful hallelujah in conjunction with the great testimonies that He has been serving us, giving us in Amazing Grace Parish. I cannot begin to tell you on the social media a lot of things beautiful, fantastic has happened.
Yes.
Out of everything that happened, the same way those days when our ships are down, we keep on moving. We keep on saying, God, we don't want to lose soul, and we did not lose soul.
Yes.
Up till this moment in time, we are giving glory to Jehovah, Lord, that He has not allowed us to die of poverty. He has not allowed us to go hunger, but He has been our means of supplement. He has been our source of supply to our needs. And I want to thank God before we return the 7 hallelujah. It's very, 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 very much in my heart to thank every volunteers, those who have volunteered to serve the community, those who have volunteers to serve each other. In doing charity, there is immense reward and grace undiluted. I want to thank every part of our social media. I want to thank every part that communicates and helps us to disseminate messages. Our engineers, the choirs, and everybody. Words are not enough from the bottom of my heart to thank you on this Christmas Eve. I am believing that on the 31st, God spare our life as He has been. We shall continue to praise His name. We shall continue to thank ourselves. We shall continue to glorify God.
Yes.
To those Amazing Grace members that are standing, you need 7 hallelujah to usher yourself into the joy of the Christmas season. We need 7 hallelujah to usher ourselves to the last 7 days, that is to say bye-bye to the menace of this troublesome year. And I pray the joy of the Christmas will be our portion wherever we may be in the 4 walks of life, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Therefore, 7 hallelujah to praise the Lord.
Hallelujah! 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 Hallelujah!
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I thank God for this grace, and I pray that that grace will not depart from our home.
Amen.
It will not depart from our family in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let us be seated and hear this very short message from the throne of grace of Jehovah Lord. We all know, and it is not new to us, what Christmas is all about. That is, every day, to my belief as a summoner, to my belief as a pastor, to my belief as a shepherd, to my belief as a priest that belongs to the royal household of the Lord, Christ is giving birth to us every day, and Christ is born every day. So, but there is a specific time and moment in the season where we have to remember and recollect how it was done. And the reason and the purpose of His birth should not be eluded or be mixed in our life. The Bible made us to understand that in every situation, this day, the first and the second lesson combined. The first lesson is talking about His coming through Prophet Isaiah, telling us that how it is going to be like and what our Savior Jesus Christ is coming to do. to save us from sin, to bring unity, to bring love to mankind, and to be able to stand in gap for us between us and God Almighty. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Therefore, the second lesson made us to understand that in the next couple of hours, Christ is born in Bethlehem. Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
When you check the book of Isaiah chapter number 9, verse 6, I want to believe that we are very much conversant with it. If you have the opportunity, let us read it. That drives home the part of the second lesson where we were being told the specific nature or the geographical location of where our Christ is born in Bethlehem of Judea. Let's study the Bible.
For unto us a child is born.
To us a child is born.
Unto us a son is given.
Unto us a son is given. Yes.
And the government will be upon his shoulders. And his name...
Every other power apart from that of our Lord Jesus Christ, they are powerless. Because Prophet Isaiah has foretold us that a king is born. And he's an incomparable king. And that is why his coming was announced by Isaiah in the first lesson. And the same Isaiah is still telling us, pointing to the fact that whether the world like it or not, a Messiah is going to be given birth to. And he's coming to do only one thing, to save us from all our sins. He's a lamp that takes away the sins of the world. We are joyous and happy in this season and this time of the yearly tax season to say thank you, Lord Jesus Christ, for being born into our life. Born in a manger. And I feel that we all know what manger is. Well, indeed, a place that we can say has no value. A place or a bed where animals lives, but there is a message there that he descended so low so that we can have life in abundance, and that is the joy of the season that we share. Read the Bible, sir.
And his name will be called Wonderful Counselor.
Mighty shall be called Counselor, and that is why to every mission that God sent our Lord Jesus Christ is from one place to the other, preaching the gospel, converting souls, and faces a lot of persecution for your sake and for my sake. And the time and season will soon come near again when we'll be asking ourselves, are we going to nail him again? My message for you in this season is, be joyous, be happy. Leave every form of bothersome loneliness in your path. Leave them beside. And give glory to Lord Jesus Christ for giving you and I the grace of the Christmas. I know that many people live in a state of loneliness though. Especially that you are going to be, and we are going to be by ourselves, first time, I believe, in the history of the world. That we first thought in the last announcement made by the Prime Minister that two or three families would be meeting for bubbles. But all of a sudden again, just because for us not to die of diseases of this sickness that was cancelled. So in order was children of God, Amazing Grace Parish members and everyone that will be listening to us, do not be a violator of that very particular message. It's for our own good. When you are by yourself, God is with you.
Yes.
Make sure that you enjoy the best of music. Yes. And that is why we have done that in the last couple of weeks. Just exercising the grace that God has given unto us in Amazing Grace Parish. So that at least you have a place to visit called YouTube. Perhaps your Instagram or your Facebook. But make sure that you are not addicted to watching TV in this season. so that will not develop into another stigma. But my prayer is that God will strengthen you.
Yeah.
I want to tell you that there are a lot of people that go through bustles and hustles, and they will find themselves to be alone, most especially during this season and time that we are. Believe me sincerely, it does not last longer. We are coming out of it, and we are getting out of it.
Amen.
And by the special grace of God, we will be celebrating ourselves in the household of the Lord in the name of Jesus, Lord.
Amen.
A lot of people, we misunderstood you for who you are, what you are, or what you represent, most especially during this Christmas season. If you are that person that feels lonely or isolated, embrace the fact that you need to pick up your phone to speak to somebody on Christmas Day. Embrace the fact that you have spared your life. You need to watch beautiful and good program on the TV. You need to rejoice with your home and your family without much of complaint. And I believe that God in His infinite mercy will have all His umbrella of protection upon our life in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The thought of how we are going to live our life, the thought of how we are going to enjoy the best of the new year, let us remember the book of Proverbs that there are many plans in the man's heart. But he said, nevertheless, the counsel of God shall stand. He that created the eyes knows the purpose of the eyes. And for the meaningful purpose of the season, Lord shall behold all of us in the name of Jesus, Lord.
Amen.
Let us study the Bible.
What he will be, and his name will be called Wonderful Counselor.
Wonderful Counselor, yes.
Everlasting Father.
Prince Everlasting of Peace. Father, yes.
Prince of Peace.
Prince of Peace. Therefore, children of God, I have this word for you, that you should not fear. In the book of Exodus, chapter number 14, verse 13, 14, 15, for the sake of time, the Bible made me to understand that man Moses was leading the Israelites in crossing the Red Sea. I made this as a form of familiarization theme or topic for you. That because of Moses, there's a Red Sea. And because of Red Sea, there's Moses. I am making a home to understand that you are the Moses that I'm preaching to tonight. That in every Red Sea of your life, do not fear, do not panic. Because there are consequences of fear. Fear will make you to think wrongly. And please desist from that. Let us take the case studies of people like Sarah in the Bible. Genesis chapter 16, 2 to 3. A point of reflection of our life. Fear will make you to talk wrong in this season and avoid every circumstances or situation that will make you to talk wrongly. Fear will make you to act wrongly, perhaps because of isolation, loneliness, or the stigma. But I want to admonish you that with all this, make sure that you stand up on the feet and make sure you keep going with the propelling will God has deposited in you, which is the power of the Holy Spirit. Do not allow anything to hinder your relationship with God, most especially in this season. He has been with you, your pillar of strength and support. And to me, I believe that He has never despised our prayer in our necessities. Let us remember that fear is a weapon that can intimidate you, and it can render you and I spiritually impotent. Make sure that you are not impotent with any form of fear or circumstances or situation that surrounds you. Always believe that your tomorrow will be better and okay.
Amen.
And I want to assure you that this season we have is a season where we need to be well connected with our God, to understand the concept why He has created us, to understand why He has valued us so much that He has given us Jesus Christ in this season and every time of the season of our life. Let us remember His promises over to us according to 2 Chronicles chapter 7, verse 14. When we change from our sinful way, our wicked way, He promised us life everlasting. He promised us peace and He promised us prosperity. Hallelujah.
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 And this season, as this year is running out, I want to admonish you once again that you should abort anything that fear can bring in you, that can change the mindset of God in the miracles that He has lined up for you and I. There are many of us who least believe or expected God to shock them or to surprise them. But listen, on to bati pinu lokun re, o se da to. When He chooses to bless a nation, He will bless.
Amen.
When He chooses to remember it is your time, but it's your turn, He will do it. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Do not forget that a man in the Bible, in a nutshell, I don't want to take your time because many of us are engaged in cooking now. I can feel some home, I can smell some food from the pulpit right now. And I can see many of us are preparing on how tomorrow is going to be, singly with your family, friends. Remember to pray for me too. I want to tell you about Mephibosheth. Mephibosheth lived in a world where he was singular, in a country of isolation, in a country of loneliness. And the place is called Lodiba in the Bible. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Not for any reasons or circumstance, but because he lost the dad in a war. And as a reason of that, the Bible made us to understand that he was crippled. And to be a crippled, to belong to the royal house again, is another deforming of character. And in other words, he ended up being in the custodian of a nurse. And out of that, of the loneliness, nobody can say precisely where he is or who he is and what type of life he's living. But he was living in the midst of people who are isolated or skilled. And so, like, it could be, and it will not be us in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
In any situation or circumstances you are, I am just bringing that Lodiba to you, bringing Mephibosheth into Eden. Do not panic, do not fear. Just believe that your tomorrow is okay. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah. Always have that song as part of your song tomorrow, because He lives. I can face tomorrow because He lives. All fear is gone because I know He owns a future and life is worth a living just because He lives. Because He lives, your tomorrow is okay. Because He lives, you will face it and you will not run away. And that's exactly when the time of the Book of Remembrance was turned to be open. There is a king that was on sick there. Who remembered? There's a household I need to be blessed. Can we bring me the Book of Remembrance? And I'm saying this on this Christmas Eve. This word from the throne of grace undiluted. That God, who has deposited a lot of testimonies in the life of Amazing Grace parish members, in this year, we cannot fathom His grace unless we want to say we are not grateful. But as for me, I am grateful for everything that He has done. I feel like singing until 12 p.m. But the bottom line is that let us remember that the law and the guidance of the Lamb is still there for us to be obliged to listen to and to follow. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I want to make it known to you that the Book of Remembrance was open. And he was fetched. Immediately the king saw him. His situation changes. I remember the Bible says he was restored. Yes. I remember that he forgot the years of his locust. He began to sit and dine with the prince. Yes. If there's any message for somebody tonight, my message for you is that your story will go through changes in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
When I say changes, I don't mean negative, but it is going to be a remarkable into positiveness in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Matthew 11:28, as we are rounding up the sermon of tonight. Matthew 11:28.
Come to me.
Come to me.
All you who labor.
Come to Jesus. All he that labors. And as we give us rest with peace and love. If there's anything that I'm going to round up in the message of the Christmas for your home, for your family, for my family, and for your home, is that it will give you peace.
Amen.
And that peace will be an unconditional peace in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
If love is not radiating in our family, in our home, for one reason or the other, I pray for the grace of restoration in the name of our Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Because verse 29 there says, take my yoke upon you and do what? Learn from me. For I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. So in other words, give no room for loneliness. Give no room for isolation. Give yourself into music and believe in music therapy. Dance and dance into the joy of the Christmas. Engage your family and your home to dance with you. Connect with friends to rejoice with you. To say, Lord, you have spared my life. You have not allowed loneliness to kill me. And you have not allowed people to make mockery of the glory of God in me. I pray Jehovah, Lord, to be with you.
Amen.
I pray God to strengthen all of us.
Amen.
He that keep Israel never slumber nor sleep.
Amen.
His umbrella of protection will continually be on us.
Amen.
I pray that they will restore you in this year coming.
Amen.
And in everything that the locusts have eaten.
Amen.
By his grace.
Amen.
I pray that in multiple food, God will restore you.
Amen.
He will enable you to go into the enemy's camp.
Amen.
And he will take back everything that has been stolen from you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It will make a way where there seems to be no way for you.
Amen.
Because you have accepted Christ. And on this day, powerful day, that the second lesson has told us about Bethlehem of Judea, that the king is born.
Oh.
We shall rejoice together in it.
Amen.
In Jesus' beloved name, I pray for you. Let us pray. Oluwa miraka miraka
moti
moti bala
waka
praying to your Jehovah Lord, thanking him in every aspect of life, giving him glory and thanking him on behalf of your children, on behalf of your home and your family. Rejoice that to us a king is born. Remember that he's a counselor of peace, no matter what the troublesome of your water could be, he's right there in present abilities of trouble. Remember to pray for every nuclear family, extended and come on family, wherever they may be in the four walls of life. Seize the opportunity to pray for those who are in the hospital right now, whether you know them, you don't know them. Tell God to heal them and to heal our lands. Tell God to remove sorrow from all our paths and our ways, Lord. As he has promised us through Prophet Isaiah, that he will uproot all our crooked paths. I want to pray for you. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Jehovah.
Amen.
Jesus Christ.
Holy.
Holy mighty.
Holy.
On this day, on this platform of your podium ordained, I pray that we are grateful for all that you have done in our life.
Yes.
Father, we return all the glory of this year back to you, that you have been our God and you have not dispersed our prayer in our necessities.
Yes.
We will not take for granted everything that you have done in our life. As we pray for windows of opportunity to open more for us in the name of Jesus,
Amen.
O Lord. We ask, O Lord, to favor us in all dimensions, O Lord.
Amen.
That in this Yuletide season, O Lord, we will continue to rejoice in your salvation.
Amen.
That you will continue to be our pillar of support and strength.
Amen.
And tomorrow, when we celebrate with our family, O Lord, no evil will come near us.
Amen.
No evil will come near us.
Amen.
And by the time we say Christmas is over, the windows of opportunities, the letters that we are expecting, the email that we have long been waiting for joy, for happiness, shall become ours in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you for your presence.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' mighty name I have prayed.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen.